Welcome to SnackBreak. Today we're joined with Chris Cunningham, brand strategist and founding member at ClickUp. Today we'll be speaking about everything regarding, you know, content for brands and partnerships. And Chris is an expert in this space, so we're super excited to have him today. I think to just get things started, you know, give us a little background on ClickUp and what your day-to-day looks like as, you know, a brand strategist there.
Yeah, of course. So ClickUp, project management software, our goal is really just to keep everyone more productive. And we use project management as we were starting other companies in the past. So I think that we just saw an opportunity in the fact that so many different teams use different types, right? Your marketing team would be in, Asana. Your dev team might be in Jira. We thought that didn't make sense at all. So Zev was on a mission to fix that. And yeah, ClickUp's growing very fast. A lot of our day-to-day now is more so focusing on everything and getting our eyeballs on the product, right? People know project management, people are choosing it every day, but why would they choose us? So a lot of my day is looking at different ways that we can market. It can be through podcasting. It can be through, we were just on Elon Musk's episode of SNL. We ran a commercial there, very successful. And we're really, really pushing hard on out of home, being that we're not as well known as Jira or Monday at the moment, but we're running data each month as we just keep doing these out of home. Like, we have every single train here in San Diego wrapped, literally, actually. We're in every single large city with billboards. You go to Atlanta, you go in the airport, New York, Dallas, you will run and see ClickUp. That's our big push we're doing now. And we're following that out with really cool Facebook ads and creative things I'm sure we'll get into.
Yeah, amazing. That sounds great. And congratulations on the, you know, recent, or at least in the last 6 months, you know, Series B, 100 million, correct?
So yes, that's kind of 100 million, $1 billion valuation.
Yeah, that's some sweet stuff. Congratulations there. So I bet that gives you a lot of, you know, tailwind to be, you know, wrapping, you know, trains and other sources of like transportation. So that's all great stuff. You know, when you think about putting yourself out there with like the Mondays and the other productivity tools, you know, where do these ideas come from? You know, is it you at the helm of it, or like, where do you get, you know, these creative ideas that are innovative?
That's what I love about ClickUp. Like, I can't say enough, obviously, since being here in the beginning, but we can run with anything. There is no red tape. There's no holding us back. Like, there's an idea, we run. So it's not just me. I definitely do come up with a lot of ideas. I do music for our new features. That's something really creative that I've been doing. It actually was kind of like a joke to me at the beginning, but it was well received by the investing team, and they're loving it. So we've been doing songs. I mean, I'm going to the studio in 2 hours of this with a music artist to make another song. I have ideas for certain things that I can run, but we have a whole team. So we have Melissa, who came over from BuzzFeed, who's our chief of creative. She just has insane ideas. Her husband actually gives us a lot of ideas too. We've hired a team. We have DPs. We have Nick Fabiano, who we hired, who's done a lot of major commercials for Pedigree and so forth. But really, it's a whole team effort, and everything is done in ClickUp. So there's an idea section, or like list, and ClickUp, and then we just throw ideas in there. When someone sees one, they're like, whoa, this one's good. We have a whole process in how we push things in place. So we have an idea bank, then the ones that really get voted well upon move into the main part. And then from there, we get to certain things. Some week we focus on content for ads. Some we just want to be cool. Some we, like you said, we keep our ear to the street. Like, someone made a rap song called ClickUp. And the next day we made our own version of the song and came out with it, and it got a lot of press. It was cool. So yeah, things like that. If something cool is trendy, we move on it fast. Because especially like today's age with TikTok and all that, you know, trend is cool for 2 days. If you didn't make something and jump on it, 2 weeks later, no one knows even what you're doing, you know? Yeah. So yeah, the process really to use ClickUp and to have ideas, it's a whole team, and then we execute.
I feel like we just can't breeze over the fact that you're making music. So like, speak about like what are the channels of distribution there, and kind of like the goals of creating your own music.
I'm so glad you asked. So this came from a joke in like 2016. I made a rap just joking around. I was like, I think it was over Christmas break. I went home and I had nothing to do. ClickUp was maybe 8 employees at the time and hardly any users. There's a popular rap song called Nuck If You Buck, and I did like our own version of that. I really went at the competitors. Like, I was like calling out Basecamp, calling out Trello, and the video went viral. Like, it went pretty viral. It got like 30 or 40,000 views, and later got brought back up, and our company said, oh, you should do it again. So I did it, and I just happened to do it for one of our features, which was the email feature. And I went on, there's a popular song by 24K Golden, and I just kind of went on that song, and I caught it. After that, they asked me next week to do it again for the next feature. And so now with each feature we have coming out, I'm planning ahead and making cool songs we release. We do like little graphic motion designs behind it, but it's actually quite popular. We've had we've had people come to want to work for us from other companies using that example. Like the fact you guys do music is cool. So the long-term play is one we want to keep doing with our features. It's fun. It's a new, easy way. And we're not overdoing it. It's like we're out here hiring Ed Sheeran to sing for us. You know, we're just pulling employees that have a little bit of I can't sing. I'm not a musician, but I'm rapping and having fun with it just because the CEO and I, Zeb, actually, funny story, used to manage rappers together in college. That was like our thing. We had a company and everything doing it. And we actually still work with the rapper who we did in college on some of the ClickUp songs. So it all came full circle. I think the big thing is we're not afraid to try funny and weird things. Like everyone told us it was dumb at the beginning and now everyone loves it. So it's ironic. You never know. But yeah, I am making music and I'm making two more songs tonight and you know, I'll share some of the more future ones with you.
Love that. That's so cool. Definitely innovative at the forefront. And like, you can tell that, I guess, content creation is just at the forefront of like who you are. And that's why you are, you know, such an asset to like the ClickUp community. Like you understand that content's king. So I guess like speaking there, I really, unless Chloe, you want to jump in on anything here, but I was going to get kind of into like partnerships. But
I was just going to ask how do you get like so much engagement as like, were there any challenges as a B2B company that you faced in terms of creating this content? Because it's like, you know, it sounds like you're just coming up with these like really edgy ideas, but like, you know, because you're a productive activity app. So like how do you market that to your biggest customers?
Yeah, I think it's a great question. So our traction in the beginning was always low. It was really hard. And I think rather than take shortcuts, which we knew how to do, like we ran social media companies prior to this, if you know how to do quick growth and giveaways and things like that, but really isn't the go. Like I think we just focused on the core, and this is probably not sound cliche, but people will say this, you know, focus on the core you do have. And we did. But I think what really started getting our social media growing was working with other companies and doing other cool things. Mm-hmm. That's how we got in front of other audiences, like how we're going to do together. You know, both our followings will lift when we share the content with each other. So we did a lot of those in the early days. And then we just had a couple pieces go viral. We paid certain influencers to help. And honestly, that was a big part. So not only will we get an influencer to post for us, we'll also, if we're close enough to them, we can get access to their Facebook and create like a lookalike audience. And then, so imagine if you like Dame and John, and then, you know, we run an ad to you with Dame and John, you're very likely to engage in it. So that's how we really increased our engagement rates. And yeah, we've kept relationships with a lot of those people. And a lot of times us commenting on their posts and they comment back on ours, you'd be surprised what a couple of verified comments does for your engagement too. So I think with us really like working with some celebrities and staying in touch with them and them commenting and stuff, that it just seemed to kind of put us on a different level. And we kept steadily growing from there. And then our user base obviously helps too.
Yeah, these are all really good tips. We've been like trying to do a little bit more influencer marketing ourselves, but you know, it's hard to get those big names sometimes unless you don't pay in. You know, it also helps if they're passionate about the program. Are they using your program as well, these influencers?
Yes, definitely try to get the ones who are. There's some who had to teach the platform. I'd love to lie to you, like everyone uses ClickUp. There's been a few who had to teach ClickUp and make sure it was a fit and all that. But luckily I'm reaching out to a lot of like dev influencers. They're the ones who've done really well for us. For you all, you could go more wide range. If you want, I can link you to some people who can help you with that, but you definitely should talk to a few. Yeah, definitely don't overpay. These influencers are always trying to get you to overpay at the beginning. You gotta stay strong. They need a check and they like consistent checks. If you pitch them on like a 3-month campaign, which is better than, you know, having someone post one and done just doesn't make sense because people forget about it, it's over. So it's better for the influencer. It's also better for you because you'll get more value. So I usually try to say, hey, look, I know you probably get $1,000 per post. I'm not going to pay you that. You know, I'm probably going to pay you $300 or $400 per post, but I'm going to do it every month for 3 or 4 months. Would you rather have that towards, you know, rent and everything else or not? And they typically always take it, even if it is a larger pay cut, because at the end of the day, it's just a little bit of time for them. And it still is an output of money.
Completely. And I think that just goes onto the point of like building a relationship with like these personalities, like a one and done with a 90-day clause. On that 91st day, your post might disappear.
But exactly.
But with like a 4-month relationship, you're actually educating them throughout the time on, you know, and you know, how to speak the ClickUp language or the SnackMagic language, which is kind of
exactly
like the goal here. And it's kind of like a segue into kind of one question I was going to have is the ideal customer of ClickUp, going there for a second. You know, of course you have these massive companies, but what other areas do you think maybe it is like a record label and like their music distribution? Like what are some of the, you know, maybe most slept on use cases of ClickUp that you are trying to get into like that market or could just like really help?
Yeah, no, I got you. I think you guys should look at this. I just spoke to this esports team today. and we partnered up with them. And man, they brought me some of the coolest leads. And I forgot, I started a little research on how big that industry is. And you look into Fortnite, you look into these games and the money behind it. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I want in. You know, I want in. I want them to think we're cool, and I wanted to howl that we think. So I gave this team free ClickUp, and I didn't think that much of it. Next thing I know, I was like, can you just post on your Twitter or something like that? And I look back, I wake up one morning, our Twitter's just popping, because this is like they're in Europe. It's called 15 Kings. And next thing I know, they posted us, they did all this huge shout out, and our Twitter's just going crazy. And it's because they're like, this is so cool, ClickUp got involved in esports. And I didn't even realize it was that big of a deal. So yeah, after I saw the aftermath of this little partnership, that to me, honestly, I'm giving them a software that we already have, right? So I'm giving it to them free. But yeah, I think you guys should think about the gaming world too, because they need snacks and they need to get a little healthier because they're not moving so much. So I thought about it, I gotta hook up my crew with some of these games, because now all these gaming companies are reaching out to us, and we've already closed a few large deals from that. And I would have never ever thought about it. And now we're going to be like on their jerseys that they have, you know, almost like in soccer and everything else. So I think esports is a fun one that I wasn't, if you asked me 2 weeks ago, I wouldn't have told you at all. But yeah, my attention is very much so on it, especially when I studied how much money is being spent in that sport. It's like, it's wild. I mean, some of these people like Ninja are getting paid insane number, you know, FaZe Clan is through the roof. They can do anything they want. So yeah, my eyes on, that's a new one my eyes on, but I'm looking at every market. The ideal ClickUp customer is anyone who wants to be more productive. Obviously, we want more enterprise. You know, we do. I think we've done a really good job on SMB. And I think now that we're a few features away from really being that complete, you know, enterprise package. So we're on it. Our dev team is working really hard to really, I guess, expand what our ideal customer is. But honestly, anyone wants to be productive, come use ClickUp. You know, we're ready.
I love that so much. That's great. And I think like, yeah, the whole gaming community, of course, that's a market for us as well. And like a nice partnership, but that is out of the box.
Yeah, true. I was going to say, it's like if these, because I know I have a lot of friends who are like really into like streaming stuff, you know, like people playing, they're just playing games.
Oh, right? Yeah, they're just playing.
Right? Like they could just, oh, you know what? I'm hungry. Just whip out a little snack box, instant promo. That's brilliant, honestly.
I think it's a good one. I think if you had some of these gamers and you just hit them up, hey, let's give you a free box. It's like, while they're streaming, just say, oh, we asked why you're streaming. Like, yo. If you like, this is Snack Magic snacks. I'm not eating some BS from 7-Eleven. You know, you can hit it with something like that. And like, who would love it? Because I mean, we actually have some extra. I was just eating some. I just had some truffle little cheese. Like, instead of eating like Cheetos, I had some truffle, like really high end snack earlier because of Snack Magic. You know, like it's, once you have it around, you kind of get it. You know, you want to upgrade your snacks. So I think that's like as we work together, I want to show that to our like users, is just how cool the snacks are. They really are. I mean, there's like an extra fruit drink, like it was like pure fruit almost. Like, I don't know, you guys find the most unique snacks. And I know I'm really good friends with Bill Glazer, the CEO of Outstanding Foods, and he loves working with you guys, the pig out chips and all that. I mean, they're awesome. So it's definitely cool to see.
Yeah, we actually have a new section, I don't know if you saw, called Work and Play. And that's really good for like, it's more like productive items. Like there's like Idris Elba coloring book and like a sushi pin set.
No way.
Titanic ice cube. Like it's insane.
Devil love that stuff. Just cool things to have around your desk, you mean?
Yeah. Just cute little fidget things.
That's a good idea.
It's a good one.
I did a little deep dive into your Instagram, and there was this one video of you driving and you were speaking about network, and you precisely did that on our call 2 weeks ago.
And you know what's
so funny is, talk to Bill, and it's like leaving, you know, creating a safe space or a space that every conversation will lead to another seed planted. And I think like, you want to speak to that, like in regards to like how you approach building your network or like how you want to, you know, work?
Man, that's actually probably a fair question I've been asked, if I'm being honest. And for two reasons. One, that video, I used to be really, to be honest, insecure. I had a stuttering problem when I was young. I was like, I'm not gonna do any videos like that because I see everyone doing it. My friend was like, we're in the car and he has cameras. He said, just talk for a minute. And I did. And that's what came out, because that is the truest thing. That like, a lot of people ask me, how'd you end up here? How'd you end up ClickUp? And it's, I'd love to lie. Like, oh, I'm some super genius, or I speak really well. It's like, no, honestly, I just have kind of been true to the fact that I do meet a lot of cool people, but my mind is forever always working. Like, as I meet a lot of people and getting cool opportunities, which I have from our previous companies and experience with influencers, things like that. But as I meet you, as I'm talking to you, my mind's kind of working, like, how can I help Greg? You know, what can I do? And then I didn't know Bill was already on Snack Magic. So I'm thinking, hey, look, like this is really gonna help two people. But I didn't realize you guys are already connected. But that really is what's worked for me, is my mind is already turning of, okay, how can I help this person? And it's usually not that hard. It's usually I just know someone that they should know. And that's really what it is. I'm not doing, you know, anything crazy, but that alone has given me a great network, and a lot of people trust me to do the same. And if I come back and if I do happen to ask for a favor, which I rarely do, to be honest, but if I do, you're most likely inclined to want to give it to me because I've given you like three other favors that helped you that you remember top of mind. So I just keep giving. And then when it's time for me to ask, I don't feel bad about asking anyone as long as I've already, but my rule is I won't ask for anything unless I've given you two things, you know?
Yep. And that's precisely like the key to networking is like doing good work and being a good person. And it's just like the gift that keeps on giving, and everyone, like pretty much all your connections just start working together. And it, like years down there, like Chris, thank you. So like,
yeah,
really, really cool. Like segue.
It sounds thank like you for that, man. Yeah.
I'm so sorry. It sounds like more of a community than a network, you know, at that point. Right. Cause if you just all help each other, then, you know, like,
that's what we should call it, right? What should we even call it, a network? Like, it's like, because we're not necessarily just working. Sometimes it's just positive seeing one another hanging out, or, hey, I know you're going to this event. I know two good guys are going. Like I know a lot of people moving to Miami right now. So my friend just told me today he's moving to Miami. I'm like, okay, I got three people I introduce you to that, you know, get you in the scene a little bit, or you can meet good people that have good networking events. So, yeah, I agree. I'm sure we're going to grow and do the same thing here, right? We'll think of things we can help each other, and we'll just keep going.
Definitely.
100%. Yeah, I think that's a really good segue into like partnerships. We kind of already did with getting into the whole like gaming community and kind of how like we started, even how this conversation came to be, you know, like you clearly are looking at innovative channels to, you know, conceive might not be the right word, but you know, build these partnerships from. Like, of course your brain's always thinking, but what are you looking for in a partnership with ClickUp?
Yeah. If I'm being quite honest, like one, I'm looking at your audience, you know, like who did you attract? How do you interact with them? Because just because you have a great audience, or just because you have a big audience doesn't mean it's a great audience too. Like you might be an older company who has a large audience from a long time ago, but are they interacting with you? Are they engaging with you? Are you doing forward, you know, moving things? I'm looking for companies that aren't doing the same thing as anyone else. Like if you're following a status quo, I can tell by your social media and your website probably pretty quickly. And it's not that you're not doing a good job in your business, but I'm not going to be as interested because that's just not who we are. Like ClickUp's going to win because we're different. We're not going to win by just acting like Jira. We're not, you know, like we're going to win by being ClickUp, being different and doing these hip hop songs and coming up with different type of videos and funnier commercials. So what I'm looking for in a partner is like what we have right here. I'm looking for innovative companies who I know. I really like seeing that they're scrappy as well. And a lot of times we're looking for referrals. Like right now I'm going through I haven't went outside of my network for one partnership call. If I'm being honest, I just went through, I just asked and asked and asked, and I've had plenty of calls, and I'm not taking every single one either. Like we've had big companies we've spoken to that have a great audience. I'd love to have their users. But if it doesn't make sense, we're not going to do it. Or if we can't have some fun with it, if it gets too serious or whatever, it just doesn't seem right. And we have plenty of options anyway, you know, getting kind of large, to be honest, we have a lot of people we can talk to. So our goal is just find people who are fun, really ready to really resonate with their audience, that cares about their audience, takes care of their people. Cause we do too. Like our customer service is very, very important to us. Like try writing into ClickUp and see if you can have a bad experience. They're all, I mean, I'm right outside the room of like 50 nice, very, very kind people ready to help on that side. So yeah, that's what we're looking for. Fun, move, you know, fast moving, ready for change, adaptation, all that.
That's great. What have been some experiential, like maybe campaigns that you've been a part of that you think work without, you know, shedding any proprietary ideas that can't be shared yet?
Yeah, no. When I was working for Dan Fleischman at Elevator Studio in LA, we got to do some really cool things there, get really creative for clients. I say one that stood out was for Oracle. We really got to go in and they listened to us on this. And rather than just doing a regular, like, you know, Oracle video, we hired like people with like very unique talents. Like we got like a very good skateboarder. We got a break dancer. We got like all these different parts that you wouldn't usually see this. You don't think of in tech, you know, usually think of a guy behind a computer or, you know, something like that. That's usually what the commercials are, right? So we want to switch it completely up. We just have people who are very good at what they're doing. So while they're talking about this coding and everything else, they also have someone really cool skateboarding and a girl coming by and dancing. And it just changed the whole feel of Oracle. It was a huge success. It's kind of experiential marketing because it was at an event and people were seeing it go down. But I think that's one of the more cool things that jumps at me. Dan's done some really cool ideas of like having basically flooding the internet for a day, which is, I guess, still isn't experiential, but like they have a huge event, but they get a bunch of influencers in one place, all posting the same thing, like a sign or just something off the wall. And those are really cool. So I love testing and seeing new things like that. Yeah. And since COVID, we haven't been able to do too much. So I guess it's been a bit since we've been able to try anything, but I've been chomping at the bit. So you will definitely see something soon and we can test back at that in like 2-3 months.
Love that. Yeah. And that kind of, speaking of, you know, mass sharing by kind of like an influential audience, I kind of hate to bring it up, but like that was Firefest. Like the entire internet started posting their orange squares and people were like, wait, what is this? And then, you know, it sold out in 2 days and we all know the story there. But I think experiential marketing, kind of like getting it out there.
Man, I've watched that documentary twice. Yeah, I mean, look, I don't, and that was our biggest competitor. So when I was working for Elevator Studio and helping with them, Fuck Jerry was the biggest competitor who did Fire Festival. So I mean, I can't sit here and lie. Like what they did was smart. And I'm sure they didn't know that, you know, the concert was going to happen. But regardless, what they did, what there are things that can be taken, that, like the orange squares, the famous people. But I will say, like, that is going away a bit. I think people are getting, you know, people seeing Tai Lopez's garage with a bunch of girls and the cars and all that. Like, I think, and that's what that played on, right? Firefest played on that. I think now, like, if you talk to anyone who's in that I talk to in the know, like, they already see the ads are changing and stuff. Like, we used to go pay $50,000, you know, for a really nice commercial well shot. And you might go shoot a video on an iPhone now that performs better because user generated content is outperforming this regular content. Anyone knows that. I'm not telling a secret now, but now the next step is, What is that? What's it going to next? Like, how can you make user generated content real? What does go viral? Because you can try to stage user generated. Right? I call it FUGCs. It's like fake user generated content, which people set up all the time, right? You see it everywhere, but it is working really well. So I think our goal is to really get in the forefront and think of how do people make decisions? Like, what are the cool videos we can do to still keep, one, you got to keep their attention. You know, like you watch any, if you run YouTube ads, whatever, people are all dropping in the first few seconds, no matter how good your ad is. So we're getting creative what we do in the first few seconds, but also getting creative in how we keep your attention. Cause a lot of we're different from you, right? Like you can be fun and drop snacks and all that, but we still have to talk tech. So at the end of the day, I have to make it cool and I have to make it fun. And that's what we're trying to do now, is have these videos where, as I'm walking you through a tutorial of our program, but also still making you laugh and keeping your attention. That's kind of our big focus, I think, for that.
That's great. Love that. I think kind of going into how you came across SnackMagic and how you guys at ClickUp are using SnackMagic.
I'll walk you through the whole thing. I found out about you all. I don't want to throw shade, but we used to have high expectations for it. Was it Snack Nation? Yeah, like in the early days, we really thought, like, we love snacking. To be honest, the CEO and I, like, we're pretty young. We love to snack. You know, it is what it is. We've always loved to snack. We always loved to have cool snacks around. So we thought that was going to be like our big thing. I mean, we paid, the boxes we get were small, you know, like not to go too into it. But so I'd always been a fan of that industry. And we always joked about, like, they probably have a killer. Actually, I was going to get back in touch with them because I wanted to, like, I felt like they're user base had to still be pretty good. And I knew they'd probably pivot or something. So we're going to try to, like, cheaply market. But as I was doing that, I was talking to one of our investors, Brian Rosenblatt, really good. He's like a mentor of mine. I run everything by him that I'm doing. And he gives me great advice. And I was like, look, man, like, I'm doing the partner. I'm taking over the partnership things that click up. And there's so many options. Like, but I haven't really found a company that really is hitting home that hits just like us. You know, that's scrappy, that's pivoted, that's done all this. And he named you all first. And he connected me right with your CEO. And we dove in and we hit it off. He reminded me of our CEO. I can just tell he's scrappy and smart and, but also cool. Like, because I had ideas and he was just like, yeah, I'll hook you great. Like, he was just like us. You know, a lot of other companies are like, well, first we had to get this approved. And then I was like, I don't want to wait a month for a partnership. Like, I want a partnership next week because we can do that. You know, and sure enough, I spoke to you and next thing you know, we had this set up. Now, how we use SnackMagic. One, we love taking care of our clients and we love to make our customer service empowered. So now at any time, if like, let's say we have an issue and we mess up, which, you know, very rarely happens, but let's say it accidentally did, we love to make up for it, right? So we usually get free click up, but we now have another option where you can send them a box, right? Like, hey, we're so sorry you had this issue. You know, have some snacks on us. And the thing that makes it so easy is we can send a link. So I think we're using it differently. But also with sales, when we close a big deal, we're sending it to them and allow them to choose one of the larger boxes. So when sales closes a deal, they can just send over and say, hey, look, so excited to have you. As you guys start setting up ClickUp, we want to make sure you have some snacks and you have a good week next week. So something fun, easy like that. And the last way we're using it is here. I mean, I have a ton. We buy them here. I think we set up on like every 2 weeks or something. So we have a couple boxes that come here. There's a ton of snacks running around here as well. So yeah, three ways we use it. Customer service to treat if we make a mistake, because it's a fun, you know, there's giving away ClickUp, there's giving money, but there's also like a real like, hey, I'm sorry, enjoy, this is cool. So I think we're probably doing that differently. And I hope other companies copy us on that, except ones that are in our field. As for the second Sales. I think a lot of people use it for sales, as it should. And then obviously for the office.
What a good answer. Like, the customer service aspect is that's really going above and beyond, because you're fixing like the first issue of the technical issue of why, you know, a customer may be, you know, disgruntled or whatever reason. And then you're also like, the cherry on top is like, hey, like, this is for you guys. Like, we understand what happened, and like, let bygones be bygones. Let's be happy and eat some snacks.
That's a snack.
And then keep it going. Yeah.
Well, the best part is like, I don't have to worry. We used to send like cookies and milk. That was like our big thing. But like, I'm lactose intolerant. You know, people are vegan. Now it's like they choose. We don't have to do it. It's like, it's also no work on us. We just send the link. So that you guys really nailed it by doing that and changing that interface, I think, because one, like, we're so busy. We don't have time to, if we had to choose and, you know, go through snacks, it'd be a problem, but we have no work.
Hitting on so many like points that are just like validating for, you know, the SnackMagic platform, like the open link advantage. So good stuff. I know that, Chloe, you have some like case study questions, right? That
I have some more like nitty gritty questions for you.
Let's get nitty gritty.
How was the process for you using the website, and was there any feature that was like particularly helpful?
Yeah. I know my favorite parts of the platform is easy. At the beginning, honestly, sometimes I can be lazy and like go to a secretary or the office manager and just say, hey, can you take care of this? But as I was about, I was like, hey, I'll make her a loom, showing her how to do it. And I went to go do it myself. And I was like, this is so easy. I don't have to make her like a video. Like, it's that simple. So yeah, I had no issues showing the team how to use it. It's very straightforward. My favorite feature, I'm not sure if you'd call it a feature, but I was highly impressed when you guys did this. When I was ordering my own box, because first, before we even got to this stage, you guys just gave me a free box, which is so nice for Zeb and I. So as I'm filling it out, you know, I think I'm all done, and I'm pretty picky with my snacks. I got my smart sweets, I got a cool new drink, you know, like things I haven't tried, but things I also didn't know really well. But then at the end, you guys are so slick. You pop up and be like, hey, you know what? Two extra free things on us, you know, like choose two of these, like five in 40 seconds. So I love the urgency, and I just think that's genius. It just feels cool. Like, who doesn't like walking away feeling like they got something over the customer, like an extra bonus. And like, my dad taught me that when he was, like, he ran a chain of tire stores. He was all about like making them feel like they left with a deal. Even if it's not a deal, make them feel like, and I think that like the way you guys had that in there, it was a great little touch at the end. It made me feel, I already had a good experience. It was so easy. And then at the end, it's like, oh, you're giving me something else free to top. And of course you guys are. This is great.
Are you guys using the swag component at all, or like the sticker or anything?
So we actually just had to get a new office manager. So we're working on that. We have to send you, we had a bunch of swag ordered. It wasn't correct. So yeah, we are going to send you, I think we're sending it. I think you guys are on the East Coast, or is it Ohio? I think it's Ohio. You have, what doesn't matter. It's not for this, but yeah, we're trying to make it easy, because here's the thing with swag. It's like, we want to make it easier on your team, because a lot of it can be from small to large, right? But we do have like ClickUp branded AirPods, socks. So I think what we were going to do at first was send the ones that kind of don't need sizes. And then later, as we get more into it, we'll send you like all the jackets and shirts and all that. We're definitely going to touch on that too.
Very cool.
But that's going to be for our new employees. We're going to send them a snack box. Oh, yeah. And that's the fourth one we use, you guys. So yeah, we're going to send them a snack box and then swag, because we already send them swag here. But it just makes sense to go ahead and add it to you guys and have snacks.
Consolidated, yeah. Well, I think that you clearly have like your wits about like branding and like partnerships and innovative marketing.
Do you use SnackMagic, the international feature of SnackMagic?
We will. We have for two clients so far. We just closed a deal, a pretty massive deal in Europe, and we sent it over. So we're happy with that. We, as a company, we have most of our employees that are overseas are remote, but we are looking to put an office in Kiev. Coming up soon. So we definitely will be utilizing that more. And we like that you have that, because if someone writes in, like, I hate those companies like, oh yeah, we're going to give you something. It's like, oh, I'm actually overseas. Oh, we can't give you that now. It's like, no, if we say we're going to give you a gift, we don't care where you live. We're going to send it to you. Right. So we're happy that you guys have that too.
Right. Yeah, of course. Do you know that it's really, what I think is so interesting about the international thing is that we don't ship from America. We work with local partners in each.
I did not know that part.
Which is like random people like who just applied to be a gift box curator, and then they put together these boxes, and then they like ship them out for delivery to the local, you know, employees wherever they are. And like, it's so crazy too, because we also do Costa Rica, and in Costa Rica there's no addresses, so it's like the address is like 100 kilometers to the left behind the rock. Like,
and you guys put the time in, you're like, man, we're still going to deliver to Costa Rica. I don't care if we gotta use rulers and figure it out.
Exactly. It's pretty interesting. I think not a lot of people know that. Like, they think that it's just like,
I did
nationally.
That's nice to know. My friend just got back from Costa Rica. That's crazy. I did not know that. But yeah, definitely taking advantage of that feature too.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think like the key there is we want, you know, we want to be as authentic to the recipient, and we don't want, you know, to just be like, we want to give local, you know, novelties. Thanks so much for sharing all that insight today, Chris. Best of luck at ClickUp, and we look forward to tracking your success in the years to come, and looking forward to making more content with you guys. Thanks for coming on today.
Yeah, thanks for having me. This is a blast. I almost forgot we were even doing this call. I just thought we were just having fun with ideas. So I appreciate it.
Yeah, of course.